Social Security Administration. How can I help you today?
Hello, I got a message that said I have to call here. Can you help me?
When did you receive that call?
I found it on my cassette answering machine just a few minutes ago.
All right, did you receive voicemail or it was just a phone call?
It was a voicemail, I guess you call it.
That voicemail, was there any type of reference ID number or any case ID number?
No, it said I have to call here and I face legal action.
Okay, so can you help me with your first and last name so that I can check into our system? Why did you receive the call exactly?
My first name is spelled R as in Romeo, O as in Oscar, B as in Bravo, E as in Echo, R as in Romeo, T as in Tango. My last name is spelled G as in Golf, R as in Romeo, I as in India, N as in November, N as in November, E as in Echo, L as in Lima, L as in Lima.
Can you please tell me once again your first name, please?
My first name is pronounced Robert, and it's spelled R as in Romeo, O as in Oscar, B as in Bravo.
I got it. Mr. Robert, can you verify me your date of birth, please?
I was born a poor child, December 19th, year of our Lord, 1932. I was born 1 month after Franklin Roosevelt was elected president and during the height of the Great Depression.
What is your current zip code, Mr. Robert?
06516.
Okay, I got it. So this call is to inform you that we received an order from federal authorities to place a block on your social security number. So, are you aware of this situation?
No, I was out all morning. I went to the church basement to play bingo, and then I went to the park bench to feed the birds, and then I had breakfast at the Bridgeport Flyer Diner, and then I found this on my cassette answering machine.
Did you receive any calls from the local sheriff department?
No, I was out all morning.
Okay, so have you been to the state of Texas before?
Well, I worked in Dallas, Texas at the school book depository in 1963. And then there was a little incident and my friends Lyndon Baines Johnson and Sam Giancana gave me some money to move out of state. And then I moved back to Texas in 1980, and I worked at the South Fork Ranch in Parker, Texas. And then my boss, J.R. Ewing, had a little incident, and his sister-in-law gave me some money so I could move out of state again.
Okay. So, do you have any suspect?
Well, I have a friend who comes from Texas named Ted Cruz, and he's a little bit mad at me because he ran for public office recently, and I didn't vote for him in the primaries, and I wonder if maybe my friend Ted Cruz did it.
Can you verify me your social security number in order to pull out your records and let me know what the call is all about?
My social security number is 0272419922.
Okay, give me a moment. Let me check into my system and provide you with the confidential information about this case.
Okay.
Give me a moment. Mr. Robert, are you there?
I'm here.
Yes, the thing is that someone is trying to use your personal information for identity and had committed many fraudulent activity in the state of Texas.
We have
found an abandoned car on the south border of Texas. The make and model of the car is Toyota Corolla with the VIN number TX98 2071. So, do you have any suspect about this car, Mr. Robert?
No, I never rent foreign cars or buy foreign cars. I think every American who buys a foreign car should be stripped of his citizenship and be deported. Oh, by the way, my social worker at Senior Housing says when I talk to Social Security, I should get a name and a badger number. How do you spell your name?
Okay, do you have piece of paper and pen handy?
Let me go get it. It's just upstairs.
Sorry?
It's just upstairs. I have to climb upstairs to get it.
Take a piece of paper and pen handy. Write down the case file information along with my details. Once you're ready, let me know.
Excuse me, I haven't been the same since I got coronavirus. Just another set of stairs.
Are you ready, Mr. Robert?
No, just still have to get to my where I keep my pen and paper.
Okay, not a problem.
It's in the drawer here. Okay, I have a pen and paper. Uh-huh.
So, first of all, write down my name, David Thompson.
So, is Thompson T as in Tango, H in Hotel, O as in Oscar, M as in Mike, P as in Papa, S in Sierra?
Yes. Oh. Yes. Are you right? You are right.
And
write down my federal batch ID number.
Uh-huh.
030813.
So 030813. Uh-huh.
Definitely right. Also, note of your case ID number is DC, D as in David, C as in Charlie, 4028.
So my kiss ID, do you mean someone's going to kiss me?
No. Your case ID number is DC4028.
Okay, uh-huh.
Can you repeat once again my federal badge ID number or your case ID number?
So I have badger ID 030813 and KISS ID D as in Delta, C as in Charlie, 4028.
Yes, definitely right. So I can go ahead and explain you about your case file. So let me complete my part. After that, I'll give you a fair chance to speak once I'm done. Is that clear to you, Mr. Robert?
Okay.
So that car had some blood and drug residue inside the car. After the investigation, we found that car was rented under your name and your social security number. So there are two addresses linked with the title vehicle. When we investigated, we came to know that one was fake, while other was 6200 100 Avenue Apartment B, Houston, Texas 72008. Do you recognize this address, Mr. Robert?
No.
Okay. When this address was raided by the US Marshals and team, but unfortunately there was no one inside the residence. But the US Marshals have recovered 22 pounds of cocaine, which is an abusive drug, and some documents from financial institutes like Bank of America, Wells Fargo, Chase Bank, TD Bank, US Bank. All these paperwork has under your name and your social security number. So when we were investigating these bank statements, we found more than $200,000 has been wired from these accounts locally and internationally to countries like Mexico and Colombia. So do you have the owner of this all banks, Mr. Robert?
No, I only bank at one bank ever since I came back from Nam.
Listen to me, Mr. Robert. Let me do one thing. Let me send you all the documents regarding the case right away. So, can you please confirm me your address, Mr. Robert?
My address is 1187 space C as in Charlie, A as in Alpha, M as in Mike, P as in Papa, B as in Bravo.
Sorry, Mr. Robert. Mr.
So,
Robert, listen to me. 1187 season Charlie.
then after Charlie was A as in Alpha, M as in Mike, P as in Papa, B as in Bravo, E as in Echo, L as in Lima, L as in Lima, space, A as in Alpha, V as in Victor, E as in Echo, N as in November, U as in uniform, E as in Echo, space, U as in uniform, N as in November, I as in India, T as in Tango, space, 1 3. The town is spelled W as in whiskey, E as in Echo, S in Sierra, T as in Tango, space, H in hotel, A as in Alpha, V as in Victor, E as in Echo, N as in November, space, C as in Charlie, O as in Oscar, N as in November, N as in November, E as in Echo, C as in Charlie, T as in Tango, I as in India, C as in Charlie, U as in uniform, T as in Tango, and my zip code is 06516.
Okay, I got it. So, Mr. Robert, as we checked in your records and verified that you do not had any criminal records or no such fraud activity has been reported on your social, till this happened, we do believe that maybe it is possible that you are a victim of identity theft.
I think so because I do not condone marijuana. I think everyone who sells marijuana should get a fair trial by a jury of their peers and then be given the electric chair.
So, Mr. Robert, we will suggest the courthouse to safeguard your true belongings that you claim to be yours and freeze the accounts that are created by the imposters to stop future criminal activities on your social. So, Mr. Robert, we are going to suspend your social security number and we are going to reissue the new socials to you. There will be officer from Federal Trade Commission and two US Marshals will be coming to your doorstep and they are going to show paperwork and all the documents regarding this case. So now at the current we don't know the active accounts and assets under your name which belongs to you and not the imposters. So I am filling out an asset verification form for you so that we can safeguard your true belongings and freeze out remaining accounts and assets under your identity, which has been created by the imposters.
So you're saying someone's going to come to my doorstep?
Yes.
Ah.
So, can you provide me with the details that how many assets, accounts, and credit debit cards are registered from your side? Mr. Robert, can you tell me which bank are you banking with? Because in my system here we have many bank accounts. That's why I'm asking you which bank are you dealing with?
I deal with Milford Bank. That's M as in Mike, I as in India, L as in Lima, F as in Foxtrot, O as in Oscar, R as in Romeo, D as in Delta.
Milford Bank, right?
Yes.
So, Mr. Robert, do you have any other bank account?
No.
Okay. Do you use your checking or saving both?
I use both, uh-huh.
Okay. Mr. Robert, so how much approximately amount in your checking?
Someone printed out something for me last week. Let me get that slip. It's in the drawer here. Okay, in my checking account, I have $4,736.10.
$4,736, right?
That's right.
Okay. And what about saving, Mr. Robert?
I have $73,784.17.
Okay. In this bag, you have credit card?
No, I have a debit card.
Okay. So, how much the limit are in the debit card, Mr. Robert?
Oh, I'm not sure. I never maxed it out. Probably thousands and thousands of dollars.
Thousand minimum, right?
Yes.
So how much you own?
How much do I owe? Well, I don't owe anything. I retired in 1999 and I sold my house and I moved to senior housing and I put the money from the sale of my house in my savings account, so I don't owe anything.
Okay, so in debit card you have only 1,000, right?
I imagine. I don't know the limit on my debit card, but I've never maxed it out.
Okay, not a problem. So, do you have any vehicle, Mr. Robert?
Yes, I have a car.
How much car? One, two?
One car.
One car. Which model, Mr. Robert?
It's a 1957 Chevy Bel Air.
Can you spell that, Mr. Robert?
So, C as in Charlie, H in Hotel, E as in Echo, V as in Victor, Y as in Yankee, space, B as in Bravo, E as in Echo, L as in Lima, space, A is in Alpha, I is in India, R is in Romeo.
Okay. Mr. Robert, how many years of banking are you banking with?
I have been there ever since I came back from Nam in 1969.
How much year? Minimum. Can you explain me?
I never maxed out my debit card, so I don't know what my minimum is.
Okay, it's not a problem. Any monthly social security benefits amount?
Yes, I receive social security every month.
Every month. How much?
Let me check in my drawer. I got something in the mail the other day. Okay, every month I get $2,327.12.
Okay, so Mr. Robert, let me do one thing. let me transfer your call to my senior officer with DEA, Drug Enforcement Administration, who is authorized person in regard with your case. So do not hang up the line, give me a hold. He will explain you each and everything, how to resolve this case. So please stay online. Okay, Mr. Robert?
Okay.
Give me a moment.
All right.
Thank you for the patience. Your call is disconnected to the senior officer. My name is Officer Tom Sedrock from the DEA department. It is the Drugs Enforcement Administration. Am I speaking to you, Mr. Robert?
Yes. How do you spell your last name?
Sedrock.
So, S in Sierra, E as in Echo, D as in Delta, R as in Romeo, O as in Oscar, C as in Charlie, K as in Kilo?
Yep.
And what is your badger number?
CB7171.
Okay, uh-huh.
Am I speaking to Mr. Robert?
Yes.
Hi, Mr. Robert. You was having a word to one of my legal officers regarding about your social. So, have you get information? What's the reason that you get a call?
That's right. I heard that somebody did something bad with a car in Texas, and there was drugs involved and all kinds of bank accounts.
So, what's your concern now? Before I go ahead and explain to you, I just want to know your concern. What's your concern? Is that you doing all this crime under your name?
No, I do not condone marijuana. I think everyone who sells marijuana should get a fair trial by a jury of their peers and then get the electric chair.
All right. So, right now, are you disability?
I collect Social Security. I retired in 1999, and I sold my house, and I moved to senior housing.
Are you disabled or not?
No, I'm elderly. I'm 88 years old.
All right. So, see, if you're not the one who is doing all this crime, then with the federal department, we can give you a chance for you to resolve this matter and to remove your name from the criminal record. What you need to do, you need to just be cooperate with the federal department. And if you want to resolve them, if you want to fight this case yourself by hiring a criminal lawyer who can fight this case, it depends on you. So what do you want us to do now?
Well,
you want to resolve the matter by being cooperating with the federal department, or you want to hire a lawyer and fight this case?
Well, I have a lawyer friend, Saul Goodman, but he's a bit expensive. I would rather cooperate with the government.
All right. So here, if you want to resolve the matter, what I'm going to do now, in this time, I will be sending your resolve this matter to the higher commission. If they give it an approval, we can go ahead and resolve the matter. So what I'm going to do here, I will be sending the documentation. And here, right now, to send a resolve this matter, we need a one ID proof. Your ID proof. Any kind of ID proof. Do you have any kind of ID proof, like a driver's license or state ID?
Yes, I have a driver's license.
All right. Can you send me on my direct line number right now? I need to attest on the documentation.
What's the number?
Well, hold on. Let me provide you. Yes, hello?
I'm here. Uh-huh.
All right, thank you for holding the line. I have sent you the text message. I have just text you hello. Have you received any kind of message?
It's hello from 719-223-0620.
Yes. So can you click the picture and send it right now? Make sure that do not disconnect the line too, okay?
Okay, it'll take a few moments.
Mm-hmm.
Da 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 da
Love. Hello. Is your name Robert?
We are not able to take your call right now. Goodbye.